Hi friends, welcome to Ahlu Arts channel. I am your host Uma. In this video, we are going to see how to crochet a daisy square. Okay, we can use, I am using yellow and so I call it as a daisy. You can use any color, you can use many colors in the same blanket so that it can be a colorful blanket. Okay, it will be very cute. It will be a best gift for any baby shower or newborn baby. Okay. So let us start doing this. It's very simple, only we have to know all the basic stitches like double crochet and triple crochets. Okay, so this is the color I'm using for the first round so that when I use this for the petals, it seems like this is a stalk and this is a petal. So I'm using green color, and for the outer square I'm using white color. Okay, you can choose any colors as long as the colors complements each other. Okay, so choose your colors wisely, and now we are going to make a magic ring. Roll over your fingers, let the long loop on the back side insert into your first loop, pull up the second loop and chain one. Okay, we have a separate video for the magic ring also. Chain two. This will not be considered as anything. Okay, so we have to do 12 double crochets separately. 1, 2. Keep your double crochet not so tight because we will be working the next round in between the double crochets, not on the stitches. So no need to work the double crochets as so tight, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Okay, now pull this out so tight and slip stitch into the first stitch. We have done only two chains, so that is not a stitch. So first slip stitch into your first double crochet, right? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Now what we have to do, don't cut this off because we have not done any knots so far, so this has to stay. We have to weave in this. If we cut this off, then the square will be unsecured. Okay, now chain one and cut this long tail. Now pull this off. Now we formed a knot. Okay, so now we have to join the next color. We can join that in any sides. Okay, I usually join on the exact opposite side so that when this tail end comes to an end, the next tail end starts, so that it will be no overlapping. See, if I start from here, this tail end will be weaved in along this way and before this tail end starts, and we can weave in this alone. Okay, so start with the slip knot. Don't insert on the stitch. Okay, insert in between the stitch, right? Then only it will be, these two double crochets will be seen as a stalk for the petal what we are going to do now. Okay, see, I'm crocheting in the post, not on the stitch. See, on the post, not on the stitch. Insert, chain three. Now do three triple crochets. Okay, yarn over twice, insert, pull up a loop, crochet, pull through two, again another triple crochet and another triple crochet. Now we have 4 triple crochets, right? So now we have to slip stitch from the first stitch to the last stitch. So what we have to do is take your hook out of your loop, insert into the first chain, and then do a slip stitch. See, by this way your first petal is formed and it will be a bulged one. Okay, again we have to do chain 2 and then start the next petal. Next petal should be in the gap of next 2 double crochets. So 4 triple crochets, 1 2 3 4. Now take your hook off your loop, insert into the first triple crochet, then pull this out. You see what we are doing here. Now since we are working on the post of the double crochets, it seems like this petal is having a separate star. Okay, now chain 2 and I'm going to continue the same all through the round. So I'll have 12 petals at the end of this round. Okay, I'll do one more petal on camera so it will be easy for you. See, 3 double crochets and this is my 4th double crochet. Take your hook off your loop, insert into the first stitch and do the slip stitch. Now you can see this forms a petal, a bulged one. Okay, chain 2. Never forget the chain 2 because this is where we will be working on the for next round. Okay, so don't forget the chain 2. Continue the same till the end and I'll meet you at the end of this round to make this flower into a square. Okay, see, I have completed the petal round and don't forget the last chain 2. Okay, and finally slip stitch into the first slip stitch of the first petal. Okay, see, if you want you can attach a little hairpin or bobby pins or hair clips here and you can use this as a normal hair clip. You can have. Okay, so if you want a square you can attach the new color and then continue. Okay, you can not only just like on all the other squares, you can not only make these as a blankets, you can use this for tops, bags, crop tops, summer tops, tank tops, anything you can make. Okay, so attach the new color, fasten this off, chain 1 and fasten this off. Now start the third round in any of the chain 2 spaces. Okay, chain 3, that will be our first double crochet, another double crochet, another double crochet, chain 2. Wherever you start, consider that as a corner. So what we will be doing in all the corners for granny square, we follow 3-2-3 rule, that is 3 double crochet, 2 chains and 3 double crochets. In that way you can increase the round, increase the number of rounds as many as you want without getting confused with the sides and the corners. Okay, so this is our first corner. Chain one is up to you. If you don't want the chain one, you can leave it. And in the second chain 2 space, do a chain 3, sorry, 3 double crochets, right? Chain 1. Now we have reached the next corner. Since we have only 12 petals, we have to have 3 sides, sorry, 3 chain 2s for each side. Okay, so then only we will be having 4 sides, right? So 1, 2, 3 and 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, sorry, we'll be doing one more 3 double crochets. Okay, now chain 1, do this corner, 1, 2, 3, am I doing it right? Corner, 1, 2, corner, 1, 2, corner, 1, 2, yeah, we are doing right. So, chain 2 and 3 double crochets. Okay, now chain 1, 3 double crochets, and chain 1, another 3 double crochet. See, by this way, since we are starting this on the exactly opposite side for the opposite side of the previous colors, we have enough time to weave in the first tail ends there before we reach the second tail end, right? So that is why whenever you join any new colors in the granny square, not only this square or any square, if you join the new color in the opposite direction, opposite side, then it will be easy for you to weave in the tails without any overlapping. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, chain 2, 1, 2, 3. So we have done 3 corners, 1, 2, 3, chain 1, 1, 2, 3, chain 1, and this is our fourth corner, 1, 2, 3, chain 2, 1, 2, 3, right? So now chain 1, and this will be our final side with 2 sets of 3 double crochets, 1, 2, 3, chain 1, and you slip stitch into the first stitch of, sorry, first chain of chain 3. Now if you want to continue, if you want to make a single crochet border for this, you can always do. But if you want to continue the granny pattern, you can just slip stitch into these 3 double crochets and start with the corner. That is why we will be always starting any granny square. The next the new round should be considered as a corner and start with the 3, 2, 3 stitches. Then only when you end the round, you will be here in the edge. You can simply slip stitch 3 more times to reach the corner to start the next round. Okay, so if you use any of the sides as the first stitch, then it will not be in the corner. Then you may end up into the side which again takes much more time and yarn. Okay, so this is our daisy granny square. It's kind of like a 3D effect. Okay, it will be very good for, as I already said, it will be very good for bags, handbags, tops, and especially for baby blanket. You can make us a couch throw, which will be most welcoming one, right? So try this out, share your photographs in our Facebook page or group, subscribe to the channel, hit the bell icon so that you never miss any video. Thank you. Bye bye.